स्टूडेंट्स, स्वागत है आपका आपके अपने यूट्यूब चैनल SRGC HOD इलेक्ट्रिकल पर। एक बार फिर से लेक्चर नंबर 9 के साथ मैं रोहिताज सिंह। तो जैसा कि आप लोग जानते हैं कि दिस इज़ द सीरीज ऑफ सिंगल फेज ट्रांसफार्मर एंड इट इज़ द लेक्चर नंबर 9 इन विच वी विल कंटिन्यू द सिंगल फेज ट्रांसफार्मर विद एफिशियंसी ऑफ ट्रांसफार्मर एफिशियंसी ऑफ ट्रांसफार्मर। सो इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द ओपन सर्किट एंड शॉर्ट सर्किट टेस्ट टू एस्टिमेट द नो लोड आयरन लॉस एंड फुल लोड कॉपर लॉस। सो दिस नो लोड आयरन लॉस एंड फुल लोड कॉपर लॉस विल बी यूज टू डिटरमाइन द एफिशियंसी ऑफ द ट्रांसफार्मर। तो वट इज द एफिशियंसी? एफिशियंसी ऑफ ए मशीन इज नथिंग बट इट इज़ द हाउ मच पावर वी आर गेटिंग एज द आउटपुट इन कंपेरिजन टू इनपुट पावर, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द एफिशियंसी। तो एफिशियंसी ईटा इज इक्वल टू दैट इज पावर आउटपुट अपॉन पावर इनपुट, दिस इज पावर इनपुट दिस। एंड वाट इज पावर आउटपुट? ईटा इज इक्वल टू पावर आउटपुट अपॉन what is the power input? If we consider all the losses in the transformer and if the all losses are added in the output, then we will get the input. So we can write power input is equal to power output plus losses. And we know in case of transformer, because transformer is the static device, that's why there are no rotational loss. There are only two kinds of losses, that is no load iron loss and full load copper loss. So we can write here, this is power output plus iron loss plus copper loss. This is copper loss. So eta is equal to, if the rated KVA is, output KVA is V2I2, it is the rated means this is the full load KVA, output KVA, that is V2I2, and the power factor of the load, suppose this is cos phi. So output power will be, this is V2I2 cos phi upon V2I2 cos phi plus no load iron loss, that is PI, plus full load copper loss, that is PC. So if we have to calculate the percentage efficiency, that in percentage eta is equal to V2I2 cos phi upon V2I2 cos phi plus PI plus PC into 100. So by using this formula, we can calculate the full load efficiency of the transformer. So this formula is applicable for full load efficiency. Why I am telling about the full load efficiency? Because this formula is applicable only when the transformer is operating under full load condition. Now it is not necessary that always a transformer operates on full load. It may be half of the load, it may be 1/4 of the load, it may be operate on no load. So this is not a generalized formula. This formula is only applicable when the transformer is under full load condition. So we have to write down a generalized formula to determine the efficiency of the transformer. So let X is equal to, this is load factor, it is load factor. Load factor means it is the factor by which the load is changing, and its range will be in between 0 and 1. When X is equal to 0, it means it is the condition of no load, means there is no load on the transformer. And when X is equal to 1, then it is the condition of full load. It is the condition of full load. So the load may be from no load to full load. Now, what do you mean by the load factor? Load is nothing. In electrical engineering, load is nothing. It is the secondary load current. It is the load current. It means if there is a factor of load, it means the load current is changing. As the load on the transformer will change, proportionally the load current will change. It means under a load under a load, that is x times the full load, x times the full load, where x is the load factor. Eta will be equal to how much? At full load it was V2I2 is the full load kVA, that is rated kVA, into cos phi 2. This is the rated output power, but now the current has been changed by a factor of x, because load means secondary current, so it is changed by a factor of x. So now the output power will be x times of V2I2 cos phi 2 upon x V2I2 cos phi 2. Or we can write this is secondary load power factor is suppose cos phi 2 plus no load iron loss, that is PI. यहाँ पर एक चीज का ध्यान रखेंगे, when the load is changing on the transformer, that the output power will change. Why output power change? Because the load current is changing, and when load current is changing by a factor of x times, then the output power will be also x times. But keep in mind always the iron loss do not change with change in current, because iron loss depends upon the voltage and frequency. It doesn't not depend upon the load current. That's why at any load condition the no load iron loss will remain constant, and this type of loss is known as the constant loss. Plus now what will be the copper loss? So suppose copper loss is, this is PCU, this is copper loss at a load factor of x times the full load. Now check what is the value of PCU. We know that full load copper loss is PC. It is denoted by PC. Copper loss at a load factor, at a load factor x times the full load. Now copper loss is denoted by PCU. Here the copper loss, suppose this was I2 square into R equivalent. This is the total copper loss of the transformer. In the previous lecture I have explained the total copper loss can be determined either the primary current or secondary current by taking the total resistance of the transformer. So copper loss PCU will be, now the current has been equal to x times the I2, so it will be x into I2 to the square R equivalent. So PCU is equal to, can be written, x square I square R equivalent, that is x square times of PC. So in this way we can calculate the copper loss at any load. So copper loss ka generalized formula kya hoga? PCU is equal to x square times of PCU. So at no load x is equal to how much? It is 0. So copper loss will be equal to 0, because at no load the current I2 will be equal to 0. So PCU will be 0. At x is equal to 1/2, suppose load is how much? It is half of the full load, then PCU will be equal to, this is 1/4 times of PC. So you can see here that a reduction in load as 1/2, there is a reduction in copper loss as 1/4. So a small reduction in load may reduce the copper loss in significant value. Similarly, at x is equal to 1/4, suppose x is equal to 1/4, so PCU will be equal to how much? It is 1/16 of PC. And similarly, agar hum baat karte hain full load ki, to at full load means, keep in mind x is equal to 1. So when x is equal to 1, PCU is nothing but it is equal to PC. So dear student, keep in mind that is very important concept of copper loss. It is the generalized formula of copper loss. PCU is equal to x square times of PC, and you are eligible, or you are applicable to calculate this copper loss at any load on the transformer. So from here we can put the value of PCU. PCU is the copper loss at x times the full load. means at a load factor of x. So eta is equal to, now will be equal to how much? It is x v2 i2 cos phi 2 upon, this is x v2 i2 cos phi 2 plus no load iron loss, it will not change at any load, plus this is x square pc into 100, if we have to determine the efficiency in percentage. So this is the generalized formula of efficiency, and this formula is applicable for any type of load at which the transformer is operating. So it is the generalized formula for efficiency. You can see here, by putting the value of x is equal to 1, you will get v2 i2 cos phi 2 upon v2 i2 cos phi 2 plus x square means 1 into pc, and this is the formula of full load efficiency. So this is about the efficiency. Now one very important topic is there, as an electrical engineering we want the more and more efficiency of a machine, and our purpose is to minimize the losses. So we have to find that at what type of load, at which load the efficiency of the transformer will be maximum. So we have to drive the condition for maximum efficiency. So this is very, very important topic, that is condition for maximum efficiency of transformer. In various exam, this type of question is asked, that the what is the condition for maximum efficiency of a transformer, yeah, what is the load at which the efficiency of the transformer occurs maximum. So we know that generalized formula of efficiency we have derived, that is eta is equal to, this is x times v2 i2 cos phi 2 upon x v2 i2 cos phi 2 plus pi plus x square pc. This is suppose equation first. We are considering that the transformer is not operating at full load. It is operating at a load factor of x times the full load. So for maximum efficiency, for eta to be maximum, the derivative of eta with respect to variable is what here? It is the load factor, because we are changing the load and we want to check the load at which the efficiency occurs and it is maximum. So d eta upon dx should be equal to how much? It is 0. It is the condition for maximum efficiency. So d upon dx of, this is x v2 i2 cos phi 2 upon x v2 i2 cos phi 2 plus pi plus x square pc is equal to 0. So we will use the formula of a upon b to differentiate this with respect to x. So it will be x v2 i2 cos phi 2 plus pi plus x square pc to the whole square, and this is b is what? That is x v2 i2 cos phi 2 plus pi plus x square pc, as it is b is at is, and differentiation of a. So differentiation of a with respect to x will give v2 i2 cos phi 2, that is v2 i2 cos phi 2 minus a is as it is, means x v2 i2 cos phi 2 will be as it is, into differentiation of b with respect to x. So it will give you, that is v2 i2 cos phi 2 plus pi will have zero differentiation, and x square pc is how much? This is 2x into pc is equal to 0. So here you can say that it is a upon b, this part, whole part, numerator is a and denominator is b. So if a upon b is 0, it means a will always be 0. So we can write that is x v2 I2 cos phi 2 plus pi plus x square pc into v2 I2 cos phi 2 is equal to, this is x v2 I2 cos phi 2 into v2 I2 cos phi 2 plus 2x pc. So from here you can see that v2 I2 phi 2, v2 I2 phi 2 is cancel out. So we have x v2 I2 cos phi 2 plus pi plus x square pc is equal to, this is x v2 I2 cos phi 2 plus 2 x square pc. From here x v2 I2 cos phi, x v2 I2 cos phi is cancelled. So this is pi plus x square pc is equal to, this is 2 x square pc, or x square pc is equal to pi. So you can see here what is x square pc. This is the copper loss at a load x times the full load. So we can write this is pcu is equal to pi. And you know what is pcu. Pcu is the copper loss, and copper loss changes or varies as the load changes. So copper loss is nothing but this is variable loss. So this is variable loss, and pi is nothing but it is constant loss, because it does not depend upon the load, it depends upon the voltage and frequency. So this is constant loss. So this is very very important condition, that the efficiency of the transformer will be maximum only when the load on the transformer is such that variable loss is equal to constant loss, or the copper loss is equal to iron loss. So this is the condition. Now we have to calculate what is the load factor, what is the load factor and load at which the efficiency is maximum. So for maximum efficiency, for maximum efficiency, we have derived that x square pc is equal to how much, that is pi. Keep in mind pc is nothing but it is always equal to full load copper loss, it is full load copper loss. So from here we can calculate the load factor, x is equal to under root pi upon pc. So this is the load factor, this is the load factor at which the efficiency will be maximum. X is equal to under root pi upon pc. Pi is nothing but it, this is the no load iron loss, and pc is nothing but it is full load copper loss. So we have also calculated the load corresponding to maximum efficiency, corresponding to efficiency, that is x v2 I2, means this is the, we can calculate what is the load at which the maximum efficiency occurs. So it will be equal to x times the full load, this is the full load or rated load, that is v2 I2. Similarly we can draw a curve between the load factor x and the efficiency, means this is the variation of efficiency with respect to load factor. When the load factor is 0, that corresponding load on the transformer will be 0, that's why output power will be 0 and efficiency will be 0. As the load on the transformer goes on increased, then the efficiency corresponding increases, and there will be a particular point at which the maximum efficiency occurs. This is the point at which eta is equal to, this is eta max. So this is the point at which the load factor is equal to under root pi upon pc. Pi is the no load iron loss and pc is the full load copper loss. So dear student, in this way we have obtained the formula for efficiency, generalized formula for efficiency, condition for maximum efficiency, and the variation of efficiency with respect to load. So aaj ke is lecture mein itna hi. In the next lecture we will discuss some important problem based on single phase transformer. So, student, you are requested to subscribe the channel, share and like the video. Thank you.